Hi everyone, it's Asia here. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm gonna be showing you an upgraded this time version of art journals, handmade art journals. I've already made one version. This time I made it a little bit better. There is also gonna be a giveaway. Either one or two of these journals I'm gonna give away to my old or new subscribers, depending if people are really interested. And these are the conditions I was working off for most of the half of my movie. This is Croc, my very, very helpful cat. This time I made quite a big bunch of notebooks, but I want to start with those two. One is an agenda from this year, which I don't need because I have two. I got it as a gift and I really love the cover. And the other is agenda from some other year. And with this one I have a problem, there is a date stamped on it in the on the cover. But I decided to leave it and use it as an art journal for this year. So like that, there is gonna be a date, 2019, straight away. I'll know that I made this journal in 2019, so that's my plan. And I removed the insides. I'm cleaning now the covers. Not everything I could remove just by tearing the paper apart. So I use a wet wipe to remove the paper from the cover. And I'm gonna be adding, this is a tissue which has a sticky back to it. I love that. I don't find them enough in the shops. Sometimes they have it like occasionally, some of them in the shops I always buy, even though I'm maybe not too keen on the design. But they are very easy to work with. And look guys at that, I just peel it off. I'll just put it on the surface and everything works perfectly. And of course it's much easier to do than if you take a regular piece of fabric and then you try to glue it, because you can get some warping also. And for me the double-sided tape in that case doesn't work. So now I measure the insides, leaving of course a tiny few millimeters from each side. And I am cutting the papers. This is a watercolor paper, 180 grams per square meter. And I'm folding them with my bone folder. I prefer like that because I don't know, it's quicker. I don't have the creases, so you know, the ugly creases if I do it with bone folder. And because the size, when you put them all together, of course they're gonna be, some of them are gonna be sticking out. You have to clip them on the sides with a paper clip or sort of paper clip, and then cut them or even the edges more with the ruler and the craft knife. So I have insides for one of my notebook already. I did the same with the second notebook. So I remove all the paper, all the inside cover paper and all the insides. And you've seen me measuring the insides of the book, of the cover. And because I don't have any more adhesive fabric, I'm using a vintage loft paper from AB Studio. I'm cutting it to fit the covers inside. And I'm gonna be inking the edges also with archival ink, just to have the look more finished, in my opinion. But of course, this is not necessity. And I started to glue everything with tacky glue, but then I changed my mind and I also add a layer of mud gel because I think it may hold a little bit better and it was just simply easier to spread. And I'm holding everything with the paper clips, and it's very important to also close the book before the glue dries and to see if it's actually glued well enough that it's closing without tearing the paper or without warping. And then you just leave it dry. Don't use the heat gun, just leave it dry naturally. And because I was cutting the papers from the block of papers, I had some small pieces left and I decided to make a super tiny notebooks. And for that I used, you know, this fake leather thing, fabric, and some fabric for insides, and I run it through my sewing machine like that. I don't have to glue it. Of course, you can glue it if you want, but it's enough to run it through a sewing machine. And now I'm doing in the middle dots where I'll do my holes. So you have to do two dots on the top, two dots on the bottom, and one in the middle. Just do them as close to the edges as possible. I'm talking about those two from each side, from the bottom and the top, but also not close enough so it will not tear apart the covers, the notebook. And this is the idea for you. For those of you who doesn't have a crocodile and don't know how to make a holes in the middle, just use your thing to punch the holes like I just showed you before, and a little bit of wooden board, and then just punch them by pressing firmly. And because I was fed up with doing that, and I always had to ask my husband to change the settings on it, and it's quite hard, I decided to finally buy the crocodile, I think it's called. And well, with that it's of course much easier. I bought the bigger version so I can actually do holes in the middle without any problems. And again, this is now completely different book, completely different cover. I've done two holes, or I punched two holes on the bottom, two holes on the top, and one in the middle. And I'm gonna be setting the brads in it. They are not brads, I think, but well, you know what I mean. And for some of the notebooks I also decided to add the metal edges, which is quite effective at the end. And since I ran most of them through my sewing machine, for some of them I left the threads hanging, for some of them I cut the threads when I was doing the corners. And look at that, guys, this is the some of the covers I've made. Some of them are with paper, some of them are with fabric, and if you see a small kind of folds on them, creases, this is possible to remove with the iron, so don't worry about that. This is normal when the fabric was folded, the creases were made, and that's how it is. This part I slow down so you can see what I'm doing. I'm using elastic, and I'm measuring three length of the notebook, and a tiny, I'm adding a tiny bit more, like maybe 2 centimeters more, just in case, and not to waste the elastic to have enough. I'm choosing my brads, and that's where the cut was disturbing me a lot. I'm putting not brads, my beads or decorations, and I'm putting the elastic, two of them, through the middle hole from the outside. Then I'm separating them, putting them through the first hole, the closest one to the middle, and then from the outside through the second hole. And then I need to check, like that, yes, exactly, if the part which is closing the notebook is stretched well enough. I'm pulling on the sides of the elastic, taking out the paper. And now I am cutting the elastics so they actually touch each other. Beforehand I used to do that with, I used to just make a small knot, but now I decided that knot is maybe not nice enough, and I bought these small metal tubes which apparently serve to fishermen, and they are called a copper fishing tube if you are interested. To hold the elastic better together, I'm adding a tiny bit of glue at the ends of them, and then I'm putting them together inside the metal tube. And with my husband, a very handy tool, I'm just squeezing the tube. And so, guys, you get the same effect as you would get on the elastic of your hair, for example. Then I'm cleaning it, and look, that looks so nice and so well finished. And I'm really happy I found this idea. This is this was bothering me for a long time. I didn't like to make the knots, and finally I managed to find something which is helping me to avoid the knots simply. And this notebook I'm working on right now, maybe a little bit off the camera, I'm sorry, it's a notebook with a flap. I decided to make one side of the notebook a little bit longer than the other. Here I'm doing exactly the same as I was doing with the first notebook I showed you. So the same measurement, the same technique. And look, guys, this is the flap. If you can see, I'm sorry. I cannot see what I'm recording on my phone. It's way too high. And later I have problems like that. You can, of course, make this smaller also thing to close the book. I have no idea how is it called, the small piece of fabric. And because I ran out of the thicker elastic, I used a thinner one, but I decided to do, instead of three lengths, I decided to do six. So like that, I'm using it in double, like, yes, folded in double. And when you have this small piece, you want to use it, you have to start with it. You have to thread the elastic through the middle holes. And as you can see, the cat went away and my children came. And of course, well, I am doing noise, or I was doing noise, I was playing with the beads. So, you know, my son is there, interested in beads, and my daughter is interested in the glue and the covers. And guys, even with the elastic folded in double, you do the same, so you thread it the same way. I hope you see it clearly. If not, I'm gonna give you a link just here to my first video, when I explain maybe more clearer how to thread the elastic through the holes. And basically that's it. I love my notebooks. I love the fact that finally I managed to do them nicely. Really, like, I find they are the finished elements are really well done. There are no knots in the small or for the small notebooks. I did not use the eyelets because simply they wouldn't fit together. They are too small. For the bigger one I used, but you also see some of them which weren't without, which were without the eyelets. And for this notebook, for the, because it has the hard covers, I also decided to not use them, just not to break my crocodile. And I love my beads. I love things hanging. I love threads hanging. So if you see the thread hanging, it's not because I am sloppy. It's because I just simply really, really love it. I got inspired with the hanging threads by Jen Eagle and by Didi Catron and some other artists. And this is my finished notebook, my very first one, without eyelets, without the metal tubes, just with the knots. And I love working in it. I can take out my paper and work on flat surface. And so guys, for all of my subscribers, present and the ones which are gonna join me now, hopefully, I will be drawing, making a draw. I think one of my children will be drawing one or two winners, depending on your interest, basically, in my notebooks, if you like them or not. And I'm gonna add some small crafty products as well. And well, I wish you a good luck in that. And this draw is made to just say simply thank you for supporting me for such a long time. I wish you a great day, and I hope I'll talk to you soon. Bye.